Morning, folks. Might be the last abstract I do for a little while. I've thoroughly enjoyed doing them. So this is just another one. Just try the maybe 2-inch varnish brush, or is it 2-inch? 50, yeah, 50. Right, okay. Right, I've primed this bit of MDF. It's about 3 millimetres, and I gave it a prime with some emulsion. On a sandy surface, so it's got a bit of tooth. So we've got plenty of oil, so we'll just... Oh, I haven't done the yellow. Let's get the yellow. I'm not one for using a lot of colours. I try to make do with just a few. Just a cadmium yellow pale, some burnt sienna, some vermilion and ultramarine. I think I'm going to move that vermilion. Put it up here. All right. Okay, nothing in mind. I just had a couple of minutes with my eyes closed just to see if I could, my brain would settle down, but it's usual. They're usually a lost cause. Okay, so let's just make a start with, let's have a autumn colour. I do like burnt sienna mixed with a bit of white. Oh, sorry, bit of cad yellow, pale. Bit of green, bit of red. All these abstracts are unique. I know a lot of people think that it's not. There's always that perennial argument about. Of the dichotomy between one and the other, between representational art and abstract art. And there's a wonderful play about it. We went to see it in a local theatre with a group I used to belong to, called Art. And it's about a proprietor of an art gallery and his two friends. And the proprietor bought a painting, which was on show. It was a blank sheet of canvas, about 4 foot square. And he tried to justify buying it. And it got angry, but it got so funny. There were only 3 men in the play, but it was absolutely breathtaking, really. So I'm doing the opposite, but this is a fact. This is about a quarter of the size of his one, his painting, or non-painting, as the case may be. But it was very light-hearted, sort of a great fun. Oh yeah. I have autumn leaves here, so go down here a bit. Bit red. I love doing this. Don't like the noise my easel makes. But, we had our 2 minutes silence. Hi, there we are. So we've got a nice space there to put some paint. We've got very light, I think. And so I don't know. I just follow the brush. I'm not worried about the dirty brush. I like the sort of cloud bursts, what you can do with them. Try a bit of mauve. Just deepen around this area here. Let's try a bit of blue. I love yellow, but with a bit of white. I did that. Thank you. Ah, this is more yellow out. Don't like that. Right, I'm going to call that finished. I'm going to dismantle everything. If you've not done this before, you want to try it. And what you end up with will be an absolute original. doesn't matter if people don't like them. Because you've been rest assured that there are people that do like them. I never used to like this sort of thing until I started trying it. I used to paint on 5mm MDF, and I sold several in London. Most of them weren't big, but they were probably about 24 by 20, maybe 24 inches square. The gallery's gone now, and it was run by a Spanish chap whose wife wanted the gallery. He didn't own the gallery, he was just rented the gallery, but he was lovely. Jose, the Spanish guy. And he used to sell our painting, my friend and I. Traditional paintings, but after a couple of exhibitions we had in Cotton's Atrium. But he went on to sell the unsold painting in his gallery, and I started to feed in abstracts, and I was getting about £300-400 for them. We're talking about 20 odd years ago, but alas, it went, and some brothers took it over and wrecked it. So I don't know, but people do like these things. I might be disparaging for my own work, but you never know. And let's put this on just to see what happens. Well, there we are. That's improved it. There we are. I quite like that now. So where can I put my clips? Clip on there, because I've got a photograph here. On there, and one here. Now I'm going to go to my lunch and watch what goes on with the memorial today. Sad thing is that some of the protesters, they don't realise that they're immigrants, most of them, were involved in the battles anyway. You know, so it was paying homage to and give thanks to those people. I did service in, I did 3 years in the forces. It wasn't for me really. I started off in the infantry, and I transferred to the military police, retrained as a military policeman, just as the Irish problems were taking off. But luckily, I bought myself out. Not because I didn't want to go to Ireland, but because my wife didn't want to be an army wife. So I came out. But I still have got it in my bones. And I do like these parades, especially I do like the Scottish pipe bands with the wonderful drumming. Right, anyway, enough of that rubbish. Hope you like this one, folks. Give it a title, I don't know what to call it, Carousel, something like that. But there it is, a piece of unique work. You might not like it, but it's unique. It has not been done before. Yet most of my landscapes have been. So I enjoy the rest of your weekend, and I'm going to watch this and then listen to Talk Sport for my team, Crystal Palace. My grandson's 16th birthday today, so my son's managed to get 3 tickets for his auntie, my son, and John Paul. So the sun is a lovely day. Now it's been a bit cold, but 3 o'clock I shall be listening to the, not the commentary, I suppose the mass commentary, but I'll keep it up to date with what's going on. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.